Welcome to this lesson where we are still looking at trigonometry. Now in this lesson we want to see how these three concepts are combined in one question. Okay, if you have been following our videos, you will notice or you realize that in the previous lessons that we have looked at, we have covered these items individually. Now this is one of the questions from the past exam paper, 2019 November. Okay, so we want now to see and help you get to know how you can handle a question when these three concepts have been combined. Okay, remember from our guide on how the exams does come, we said trigonometry is one of the topics that comes in section B as a standalone question. For your own information, this one always carries 5 marks. The second one, 2 marks. This one also 2 marks. So already we have 9 marks from these 3 questions. So there will be other 2 or 1 question so that the total number of marks under this question can go up to 12, because each question in our section B should have 12 marks. All right. So this is trigonometry, and we want to look at how these concepts are related. Please, if you do not mind and if you want to get the maximum benefit from this presentation, you can look at, this is cosine rule. This is the area of another right angle D, triangle, and this is the shortest distance. You can also look at those presentations as we have presented them one by one. Then you can come to this one that is consolidated to put the aspects together. Okay? So now we want to look at the steps that are supposed to be carried out in order to get to the final answers of these questions. Okay, so we can start with the first one. We are dealing with a nine right angle triangle. So when you look at this triangle, okay, from the previous lessons that we have presented, the triangle that we are given here, we are given the angle. We are given the angle here. This angle is given as 92. Then we are given 8 kilometers and the other one here. Okay? So, we did mention that when you are given two sides and one angle, when you are given two sides and one angle, and then those two sides at their point, at the point where they meet, that is where you are given the angle. Then you must know that the rule that applies there is the cosine rule. Because you may have difficulties to know which one is applicable. Is it sine rule or cosine rule? So I'm trying to help you understand, to say, how do you get to determine or decide which rule to use between sine rule and cosine rule? So I'm saying, for cosine rule, you are given two sides and one angle. And then those two sides, at the point that they are meeting, that is where you have the angle. Then you must know that you are using what? Cosine rule. So this is what we are going to apply in this case. Therefore now, after you have known that you need to use cosine rule, you must be able to know the formula. But formulas, I think from 2016, the formulas are always given on the cover of your exam. You can check them out. When you just open the question paper, on the cover, the formulas are given. Okay, so we need now to use sine rule here. Okay, we need to use sine rule. So let's see the process that is supposed to be carried out. We need to use sine rule here. Let's see the process that's supposed to be carried out. So you know that this side here, KM, when we want to use letters, it is represented by the small letter what? M. Small letter M squared is equals to this side here, this side, okay, which is opposite to the angle at K, is represented by the letter, small letter K, plus also this side here that is opposite to the angle at N is equals, is represented by the letter M squared minus 2KN cos M. Okay, this is what the cosine rule states. And we are using the letters that are given here. You discover that what is going to be given in the exam or on the formula, they will use the letters A, B, C because those are the common letters. But here we cannot use A, B, C, D. We need to conceptualize the question because in the concept or in the question, with the letters that we have, it's K, and so those are the ones that we're supposed to use. Alright? So when we're using the small letters, this side KN, using these letters that were given, it's represented by the letter M, small letter M. So we can go on and say our M here, small letter M, is equals to the square root, okay? When we take out this, because to get rid of this square, you need to square both sides. When you square this side, you get rid of these two. So it is as good as we say you square the other side. So what do we have? K squared plus N squared minus 2KN cos M. Alright? So the next step is going to be, so what is our K? I told you that you come to the triangle. K is this opposite side to this angle here. So our K is 10. So we are going to put 10 squared plus, what is our N? Our N is this side that is opposite the angle at N. So it is 8 squared minus 2 multiplied by, what is K? 10. Multiplied by 8, multiplied by cos, the angle at M. What is this angle M? Here, it is 92. So we need to get 92 and put it here. Alright, so after we have done this, the rest of the work has to be done by the calculator. Okay? Now, depending on the type of the calculator that you are using, it's very important that you enclose everything that you are working out here in brackets, okay? So that the root can apply on everything here. Some calculators, as you enter these numbers here, it will be extending the root. But some of the calculators, the root will just end up applying on the first number that you are going to insert. So that is why I'm advising that you put the brackets. Then that will mean everything in the brackets, the root does apply. Are we together? So we can do that. We can apply our calculator. We can use our calculators to do this. Okay? So we do our root. Open brackets, 10 squared plus 8 squared minus 2 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 8 multiplied by cos 92. Oh, this is 92 here. Take note, this is 92. Cos 92, close brackets, equals to, okay? So what I'm getting here, I'm getting M is equals to 13.02243908, okay? Now remember, the units that we are dealing with is kilometers, so this is supposed to be, you can put kilometers here. But usually in an exam, if you read your question paper on the instruction here, there is an instruction, the last part. If the degree of accuracy is not specified, what are you supposed to do? You write all your answers correct to what? Three significant figures. Correct to three significant figures. So even this one, we need to do that. So we know that this K, this M is the same as what? KM. It's the same as what? KM, which is equals to, you round off this one correct to three significant figures, we we have 13.0. Okay, we get rid of this part, KM. This is our answer for the first one. This is our answer for the first one. All right, so you get 5 marks in the exam here for doing this work. You get 5 marks up to this point. All right, good. So you saw what we got. KN is equals to 13.0, which is as good as 13. So our next question now is the area of the triangle. Okay, just like I did in case that we made a presentation also specifically that talks about area. So you, please, it's a 7 minute lesson, so if you can 7 minutes lesson, you can watch it so that you get also the maximum benefit from this. So now, how do we find the area of this triangle? I'm sure you know that we are coming from area is equal to 1. We use this one when we are talking about a right-angled triangle. What about for triangles that do not have the 90 degrees as one of the interior angles? So this is what we want to look at. The formula that we want to use here, which is also given in the question paper. Alright? So we are going to say the area is equal to 1 over 2. Okay? The angle is M. So you do not use this. You use the other two sides. You use the other two sides, which is going to be KN, then sine M. This is the formula. Okay? But in the question paper, you discover that what is used there are the common letters, which is ABC. Okay? Now, here we are applying the letters that are in the question. Alright? So this letter is the letter that has the angle. Then the other two, they have the sides. Alright? So if you don't, you know this is the same as 0.5. So we can say 0.5. We can say 0.5 here. Okay? We can say 0.5 multiplied by K. What is our K? Our K is 10 multiplied by, what is our N? Our N is 8 multiplied by sine, the angle, which is 92 degrees. Then we do that on the formula. What do we get? Alright? What are we getting there? What are we getting? Let's okay. So we are going to get our area is equals to 39.9753308. Okay? Now remember what we talked about rounding off to three significant figures. Three significant figures. So this is going to be what? We need 1, 2, 3. So we need to get rid of the rest. Now this number is greater than 5. So we need to add now a 1 to the preceding digit. Now we know we are not going to write 10 here. So that will end up spilling over to this one. And again here this becomes 10. So again you can't write a 10. So we end up having a 4 on the other side. So this is going to go at 40.0. If you like. Okay. Cent. That is in kilometers, kilometers squared. Remember that we are dealing with what? Area. We are dealing with the area. The unit for area is square there. Okay. This is basically what we are supposed to know about the area. It's about this formula. We are just applying things that are given in the question paper. So that is why this question is one of the questions that you must correctly handle. Okay. So we go to the last question. The shortest distance from M to KN. Supposed to be this part here. To KN. Okay. from M, which is this point here, from M to what? So, the shortest distance, okay? The shortest distance, so this means that from this point, okay? This means that from this point, you need to go directly at the shortest distance, straight. From here, we go up, okay? So this, here, we have what? A 90 degrees, that is what is going to be formed. So it is like now, a right angled triangle is born, okay? So we need to find the shortest distance, this point. In other words, it's like we are talking about height of this triangle. We are talking about height of this triangle. Now, if you remember, or if you can recall where we're coming from in the previous grades, finding the area of a right angled triangle is the easiest thing because the formula that we always use is it? Okay? Here. This is the formula that we use. Area, we use this part here in this case. Now, you are going to notice that when we come to this part, the area is already given. So what we have done is to rewrite the work for you so that we do not give you problems where we have made h the subject of the formula because h is the shortest distance. When they are talking about the shortest distance, we are referring to the height here, which is the perpendicular height from this point up to that point. Alright, so we have made b the subject of the formula, and if you make d the subject of the formula, you will discover that you are going to have 2a is equals to bh. You divide this side by B, you divide by B. You are going to end with what? H, which is the shortest distance, is equals to 2A over B, which is the base. A is the area. Are we together? So, we are proceeding now. This, the shortest distance is the perpendicular height here. So we are going to go on and say 2 multiplied by 40, which is the area, divided by the base. The base, what is our base from this point up to this one? So our base becomes this line here, okay? Our base becomes KN. That is our base. That is our base, where this height forms a 90 degrees. That is the line that we are going to call our base, which is the 13. So we can divide that one. What are we getting? We are going to divide this one, and so we are dealing with this one was, okay, take note of that. So let us divide here. What are we getting? We have 2 multiplied 40 divided by 13. We are getting h, which is the shortest distance, is equals to 6.1534. All right. So then we need to make sure that from this point now, it's a question of us rounding off to round off to. Okay. So we can write our final answer here. Okay. This, we can now say the shortest distance, from M to KN is 6.15 kilometers. 6.15
meters.
All right. So basically, this is what you are supposed to do. This is what you are supposed to do. And this question has been drawn from a past exam paper. The first one here, you get 5 marks. This one, you get 2 marks. This one also gives you 2 marks. Then there are 2 more questions that will give you 3 marks, so that the total number of marks under this question, you have 12. Okay? So basically, this is what you are supposed to know here. But here, we are trying by all means to make these presentations classrooms, okay? We are trying by all means to make these presentations a classroom. So I'm going to give you an exercise. I'm going to give you an exercise so that you don't have a problem. So let me give you an exercise. Okay, so this is what is supposed to be done. Now, I felt that maybe before I give you an exercise, like I did indicate that our interest here is to examine all the options that an examiner would think of when giving you these questions. So I thought that let me rewrite this same question and show you another way in which the question can be asked. And then you're going to wonder to say, is this cosine rule? So that is what I want to do. Let me show you that thing. Okay. Okay, so here we had an angle where KMN is in. So I want to get rid of this angle here. I want to get rid of this angle. And then I say KN is equals to 13 kilometers. Then my question here is going to be calculate what? This angle. And I want to show to you the process that is supposed to, it's actually the same formula, but how do you rewrite it in order to get this? Then the rest of the questions are the same. So the question here, instead of KM, now here will be saying calculate angle. What is this angle? KMN. Or it can also be just shown calculate something. What is this? This is it. Or KMN. This is also an angle. When they say calculate this, this is a symbol like for an angle, the same as this. Where you have this. Okay? So in this question, what we are going to show to you is just how to find this angle. As for these ones, it is the same process and the same answers that I got. So the process that will be carried out here is just to show you how you can use that same formula to find the angle. Okay, so I'm going to invite my friend Mr. Piri Kamban to handle the other, just to show to you how you can find the angle. So you can come.
All right, friends, let's see how we can get the same angle using another approach. Okay, so this is Roman numeral 1. Of course, we are not going to 2 and 3, as he has already explained. So we want to find angle KMA, which is this one, alright? So like he said, when you are dealing with the cosine rule or sine rule, this angle, this side is M, then this side is K, and this side is what? A, alright? So if I want to find the M, alright? In one of the videos, we explained how you are supposed to find an angle. We said you are going to say cos M, alright, is equal to, so if you are dealing with the cos M. The sides that you're going to start with are K and N. So you're going to say N squared plus K squared minus the side opposite to this angle, which is what? M. Alright? Then you say M squared. Everything should be divided by 2NK. Alright? This is the formula that you're supposed to use. If you are dealing with it, N, it will be the same, but you start with the other two sides. Then the N should be at the end. Okay? Then you're going to say, okay, cos M is equal to, what is our N? Our N is 8. Okay, so we'll say 8 squared plus, our K is 10. 10 squared minus, what is our M? Our M is 13, so we'll say 13. Alright, squared. Everything here should be divided by what? 2 by 8 by 10. Alright? So here we need to apply, we need to work it out using a calculator. So cos M is equal to, so. Alright. So when you work it out on a calculator here, you're going to get negative 5 divided by, when you multiply here, you get 160. Alright? Now, here you don't need to worry. Your target is to get M, isn't it? So how do you get M? You get the cos the other side, but as it comes here, it becomes an inverse. So you say M is equal to cos inverse of negative 5 divided by 160. Alright? And then this you can find on the calculator. How do you do it? You start with the shift or second function. So say shift, then cos. Alright? Say open bracket, negative 5 divided by 160. Alright? What do you get? You are going to get M is equal to 91.7908466. Okay, so now our number is, you round it off to two, three, one decimal place, of course. Remember, we are dealing with degrees. Degrees is one decimal place. Any other measurement is three significant figures. So what you are going to say, we'll say 91 point. So here you count one digit and cut here and consider this one. So you're going to say this 9 is 1 because it's above 5. Below 5, it's 0. 5 and above 1. Okay? So this one is going to be 1. 1 plus 7. You have who? 91.8. Alright? That is supposed to be our answer. Now, earlier on, we had 92 here. There's no difference between these two. If you round it off here, to the nearest degree, you are going to get 92 here. Okay? But here we are following the standard that you are supposed to follow in 90 in the exam. If you are dealing with the degrees, it's supposed to be one decimal place, which is 91.8 degrees. That is how we are going to get that one. Which is the same with that. Okay, so that's the answer. And that's where we end for this presentation. But we are going to give you an exercise. So what we'll do, we'll just subject the questions via the camera to be able to copy on your own and attempt them. Thank you so much.